I know you're somewhere out there, somewhere far away. I want back again with another episode of All About Real Estate. So if you are someone who lives on rent, or if you are someone who has put out your property on rent, then this video is for you. Your life is about to change, all thanks to the new Model Tenancy Act, which is now in place. So what does this mean? What exactly is this act? What benefits or what changes is it offering to the landlords and the tenants? Let me take you through it quickly. So I have taken the liberty to divide this video into 8 subparts, which will help you understand the very concept of the act better. So without any further ado, let's get to it. Now let's begin with the 3 A's. All about the act. So this act really proposes a complete overhaul of the legal framework of rental housing all across the country. Many have also called it as a game changer. It is of course sanctioned by the government on the 2nd of June on 2021, and this new law is a model law. So according to the definition of the law that has been floated all across, the law has been prepared with the objective of balancing the interest and rights of both landlords and tenants to create an accountable and transparent ecosystem for renting the premises in a disciplined and most efficient manner. Why is it called a model act, and what does it mean? Well, it means that it is a prototype of the law that any state or any union territory can adopt with change or without change, or not adopt at all. How come? Well, see, the issue here is that the parliament cannot pass a binding law in this case. Land is a state subject. It falls under state list. So this means that the state government has the exclusive power to control or regulate laws with regards to this. The Model Tenancy Act aims at creating a vibrant, sustainable and inclusive rental housing market in the country. It will enable creation of adequate rental housing stock for all the income groups, thereby addressing the issue of homelessness. Model Tenancy Act will enable institutionalization of rental housing by gradually shifting it towards the formal market. For example, say that you have got your work in some other town or city, you have to move there, you decide to stay there and rent, or maybe you already have done that and now you're staying on rent. But if you remember, not in many cases is a written agreement formed. What is happening is, based on a verbal agreement, rent is collected from the tenants. So this is called as informal market. Everything is playing in informal market. So to institutionalize this, the government of India has passed this new Model Tenancy Act that will help in formalizing the informal market. The Model Tenancy Act will facilitate unlocking of vacant houses for rental housing purposes. It is expected to give a fillip to private participation in rental housing as a business model for addressing the huge housing shortage. So what exactly is the need to introduce this new model act? As per the 2011 census, nearly 1.1 crore houses are lying vacant in the urban parts of India. The Ministry of Housing and Urban Affairs states that the existing rental laws are not resulting in the desired growth of rental housing because of the landlord and tenant dispute, as the owner receives a lot of discouragement. What happens is, when the owner puts out their property on rent, they fear if they will receive it back. We have seen a lot of examples and cases in the past wherein, if any dispute between the landlord and the tenant happens, the case is taken to the court, which leads to a very uncertain and unsettling situation for the owner to get their property back. Since the Ministry of Housing and Urban Affairs set a vision and a target of providing housing for all by the year of 2022, the Government of India has sanctioned this act in order to achieve the same. Now, this new act will be applied in a lot of things. It will apply to premises let out for residential, commercial, or educational use. It will not cover hotels, lodging houses, inns, or for any industrial use. Now let us talk about the changes that have been made in this new model tenancy law as compared to the existing laws. Verbal rent agreements will now be considered as illegal. There has to be a written proof or agreement in between the landlord and the tenant. Number 2. Along with that, an independent authority will be established that will be present in every state and every union territory, whose responsibility will be to register the tenancy agreements. Even a separate court will be established in order to resolve tenancy-related disputes. Number 3. A cap on security deposit has to be put for up to 2 to 6 months. This means there will be no need to pay heavy or bulky deposits in advance to the landlord. Instead, for residential purposes, only 2 months worth deposit or security money is to be paid, and if it's a non-residential premise, then a security for maximum of 6 months is to be paid. Number 4. Jurisdiction of civil courts will be barred and redressal period is described within 60 days. Along with this, if in case a dispute between both the party occurs, the tenant will not face threat of eviction during their tenancy period. And in case of force majeure, the tenant will be allowed to stay for a month. Coming down to the most crucial part of this video, rights of the landlords and the tenants. A landlord will have to give 24-hour prior notice before entering the rented premises to carry out repairs or replacement. If a landlord has fulfilled all the conditions stated in the rent agreement, giving notice etc., and the tenant fails to vacate the premises on the expiration of the period of tenancy or termination of tenancy, the landlord is entitled to double the monthly rent for 2 months and 4 times after that. Landlords will be responsible for activities like structural repairs, whitewashing of walls, and painting of doors and windows, etc. There's a condition being put forward here that if any sort of damage to these particular property is done by the tenant, then the tenant will be responsible for fixing those particular damages. Coming to the tenant side of rights. Now, the tenant will be responsible for drain cleaning, switches and socket repairs, kitchen fixture repairs, replacement of glass panels in windows, doors, along with maintenance of gardens and open spaces, among others. Act is not binding on the states, as land and urban development remain state subjects, as we discussed in the beginning of this video. Like in the case with RERA, Real Estate Regulation and Development Act, the fear is that states may choose not to follow guidelines, diluting the very essence of the Model Act. So this was all about the new Model Tenancy Act. Here is a summary to help you understand better. So that was all about the new Model Tenancy Act 2021. I hope you found this video informative and interesting. I hope to see you all very soon in another episode of All About Real Estate. Till then, stay safe. Thank you.